faceless people, eyes in the shadows, been fighting a natural will, living to kill again and again, soldiers of love, provocation, careless drones to love.
To drown. Go out of studio mode.
Now it's confusing us.
Take out the studio mode. Yes. Now it's the perfect time.
Super confusing. Someday we'll be free again. Yes.
Free again. Yes, it has.
Well, I'm not sure theme song is necessarily the right word, but
it was
the one used in the announcement trailer. Theme song, I guess, would be more. Whatever we use in the launch trailer, I guess, or whatever plays when you first launch the game.
Yeah.
We'll have to see.
I'm just enjoying here my time.
Chilling.
Yeah, I'm just chilling in the meantime. Yeah. In here also, you can get a focus on the camera. Yes, I knew it. What? Okay.
You know, it's very trustworthy that the respawner sparks while you're standing near.
And I think... Now we have a dog here, yeah. So we play 3 hero mode or...
No, it's locked.
Ah.
I think we're on a different account this time than last time.
Yes, but I mean, if we want the 3 hero mode, I can try to rush for
I think 2 is fine, but we should be showing Blaze because we haven't shown him much before.
Yeah, the thing is,
then
do you
the
want
question
to
is blink
or maybe surprise?
Let's leave it as a surprise.
Yes.
Because we've shown both of them already.
Yeah, it's like a Blaze is important one here, and now...
And also, one thing we should say, now we're already off the
Don't
menu,
worry.
But because I saw somebody asking about that on Reddit, the top one in that list of the skills is your special, the middle one is your ultimate, and the bottom one is a passive skill that's always active.
Exactly. And of course, I have here the small tutorial, because,
lucky, the best possible first upgrade.
Of course, I take the hands and look at what happened.
Yeah, man, I've been born on a Friday the 13th. You cannot count on my luck.
Nope.
Unless you want it to be bad.
No, thank you. I think I'm fine. Actually, would you play? I don't know. I'm just
You play until the first wave is over, and then I take
yeah,
the second
we're gonna
one.
We're gonna try to swap
to make it a little more dynamic, so I can fuck things up and Siri, you can fix them.
Fair enough.
All audio is low for you. I don't think we can boost all audio if he's saying everything is low.
Yes, but...
But Akalis is saying game audio is low.
The game... Actually, I'm wondering what is the game audio because it's not sound. So, it's interesting.
I don't know.
Can you hear the
game? Maybe you should hit pause while you manage that.
Ah, well, maybe that's right. That's interesting. Can you hear the game?
No, it was nothing because we had tabbed out. Like the human gun last time.
Maybe now it's even too loud or is it still too low? Let us know so we can just increase the audio. And meanwhile, yes, I'm just gonna do my thing.
Yes, you're just gonna completely own the game, unlike me.
Yes. Increase damage of enemy allies.
Voice volume is fine, but yeah, we just upped the game audio a little. Is it still too low?
Yeah, let us know if it's too low. Maybe.
Ah, it's fixed. Okay, good. Woo-hoo! Excellent. Yeah, the annoying thing is, while we're tweaking the game audio, we can't see the levels of the game audio because the game audio turns off when you tab out of the window.
Yeah. So it's like, why there is no audio? What's happening here? Nope.
Oh no, I'm just realizing. Is Blaze's gun a charge gun? Or?
No, it's automatic. No,
oh, okay.
Don't be worried. But still, it's not your ideal one.
I guess we should also talk a bit about his skills.
Sure.
Because, you know, the thing over there that's sparking, that's like a proximity mine, right?
So I do this wave and then you change.
Wave and then I take it. Because I think it... taking over before the wave is kind of mean to the person who then has to manage the wave.
Yeah.
Because they're not the one who screwed up the defenses.
I think I'm okay. I'm trusting... quite enough on my defenses to be honest, so is everything under control?
And yeah, I think you get what was it? 3 remote mines before they need to recharge?
Yeah, 3. You have 3.
Do they recharge with every wave?
No, it's with the timing base.
Ah, okay.
Actually, on the upper part, on the side, on the
I just noticed the little arrow going up.
Exactly.
But I think they did just immediately jump from 1 to 3.
Yeah,
because
I think
ended.
I missed one, and the two that was here was exploded.
They exploded quite early, but I think maybe it does automatically go full at the
Maybe they changed that, yeah, it's because I played
it would be annoying of, Oh, the wave is finished. I want to place my mine, but I have to wait 20 seconds.
Yeah, me. It's your turn.
Oh, right. Oh, and hey, that's the research. Let's see if we have anything good.
Yeah, the flame is actually nice.
The flamethrower. Shield upgrade now. I think we'll go for the flamethrower because we didn't show that one last time, right?
Mm-hmm.
Should I go for the locked door up there, or so that the research crystal stays safe, maybe?
You
already have the turrets up there.
Yeah. No, they're not.
Oh, wait. Wait. Which one was teleport again? Up or down?
The teleport. I think it's up.
Because this is quicker than walking.
I mean, you can just swap with the other character.
Yeah, but I want him to stay there to keep the defense.
Okay. Ooh.
What gun is that?
Our open invite is still going out. I think we finished the last
I think we
wave.
Finished sending them, yeah. No, it was like, are these the same handgun? But no, this one is the Grenadier and this one is the Magma Fire. I think I prefer the Grenadier.
Yeah, I think so.
Because it has much longer range. Mm-hmm. This one is more like a flamethrower and, well, technically good on bunker. I was saying to Sergio just before the stream, I'm really bad with bunker.
Actually,
like,
sorry.
Oh, the fishing MG.
It's
oh, yes.
Nice
in this case, definitely.
Yeah. It is not the perfect because the bugs are not weak against the radioactive weapons.
Oh, no. Okay. She's already on waiting. So I guess. No, wait.
Yeah,
I actually should probably put her
over
here and then get moving with Blaze.
Yeah. You can do that.
She can take care of the bugs there, and we can take care of the bugs down here.
It's a shame because it's strange because we are not hearing that right now the game. So it's kind of strange because I remember more or less the sounds.
Merchant under attack.
Yeah, the merchant. Yeah.
Of course the merchant is under attack, but.
Yeah.
Oh! I see now this. This door here actually is.
You can open it.
Yeah, after the wave, maybe.
Okay.
Not in the middle of it. Because I don't want to change the direction they move in the middle of the wave.
Yeah.
Oh, actually, we have completed. It means it's your turn. And yeah, of course, if you check the map, I fell victim to it again. Big room, I didn't see that there was a sub-room.
Yeah, I
the
saw there
side.
Are some minions coming from here.
I thought that the minions were coming, and I was like, where are they coming from? Oh no, there was another room I didn't go into. It happens every time.
So I'm gonna just destroy your economy, and then...
That's fine.
Oh,
you know my economy is always destroyed when I play humankind anyway.
No, you have a better economy than me. I think we can say that you are much better than me on humankind, and I am a bit more better than you.
Yeah, I think I have more experience on humankind, whereas you have spent more time on this dungeon.
Yeah,
because I was so busy, you know, working on the humankind stuff that I didn't have much time to really dive into Endless Dungeon.
Mm. Yeah, that's
played it a bit, but not as much as you did because, you know, of course you prepared for writing the guide.
Yeah, so I don't know if you have seen the guide. There is a
you should
basic
check
guide.
It out if you're, you know, you had received your invite but you are having trouble getting into the game. Definitely check out the guide Sergio wrote because there's some not just, you know, basic tutorialization of how to manage stuff, but some tips on how to play well at the end as well.
And also, if you prefer, because, you know, guide is written and you don't like the guides, also, our friends on the social media team have prepared some videos that is already live on Twitter. And maybe tomorrow we're gonna just prepare some kind of a post so you can have a quick access to get this wonderful videos made for the social media. Wondering what to do.
I mean, we're waiting for the wave, I guess.
No, I'm just seeing where to position myself so I can just don't waste my time. So, if the last one is here.
But I guess before we go through that door, we should definitely research the zone.
Ah, yeah, I'm gonna do it. Actually, what are you doing now? And I have a double wave.
If you think you can manage it.
No.
Oh, I love that it says reinforcement.
Yeah. It's because I'm just being a bit overrun here.
Yeah, you know, I was just checking if somebody had said anything in chat. But yeah. Anyway, we were talking about blazed abilities. The ultimate, of course we haven't shown it yet, but the ultimate is really cool because it's basically that thing the destroyer bot does. Mm-hmm. Except it's of course targeting the mobs instead of your turret.
Yeah.
So he just stands there and like fires missiles at all of the enemies around.
Yeah, it's really cool. Nice.
And his special ability is, I think, that you get the bonus damage effects of your weapon type more often. Right, we only have... No, we do still have some doors.
Yeah, you can just open it to get the extra industry.
Yeah, we definitely want the extra
and industry. Also, you have now the flamethrower, so... Nice.
Yeah, though I'm not sure we need to build it. But these are probably the last two doors, I suspect.
Yeah, but we got the chest. And also, it would be nice before just moving to the next... Ooh, yes, take it with the other.
With the other gun.
Yes, for the next. When we arrive to Procedural Factory, it will be nice to have it. Before moving, I think it will be nice also to check the hero upgrades because.
We have an upgrade machine somewhere.
Yeah.
That's the
medikit.
Is it on the map?
Yeah. Yep.
Ah, there. Yeah.
It's like a hero with a beep, going up to arrows, kind of.
Heavy Gatling. No, I think we're fine.
Is there any information about the release date? Nope. Sorry.
Not yet.
We just throw you an open dev. Don't ask more things, please. I'm not sure when are we going to announce it. Maybe soon.
At some point, we're going to announce an announcement of the announcement of the release date.
Exactly. Not yet. Sorry, but we cannot say it yet.
Plus 4 wit per monster in the room or just flat 4?
Flat 4 is nice.
But also, let's see, maybe here.
Okay. Depends, but no.
Oh no, come on. Current.
Okay. Up to you? Or we cannot.
We'll decide after the wave, I guess.
Okay.
Then you can make up your mind.
Ah,
where are the monster spawners?
You have several spawns. You can just move away from Blaze because Blaze is just defending.
Oh, wait, no, the door is over here and not over there.
Yeah. Also, Blaze is in not interesting position as well. An Unception. It's because he was protecting
the research. Don't need that anymore now, of course. Come on.
Otherwise, if you are in a bad position, you can teleport it.
Don't die! these flyers are way tougher than you'd think flyers should be.
Will be displayable on low-end PCs? I mean, yes, it will be.
Low-end is, of course, relative.
It's not relative, yes, of course. I mean, you can just finish the
shivering. But, we're still in the process, you know, of working on optimizations, which is also why, you know, only high-end Ultra are available right now because the lower settings are not properly configured,
but
which means you'd probably not get much performance. Remember the hero upgrade. You probably wouldn't get much performance increase for a significant visual downgrade. Mm. So which is why they're turned off.
Actually, don't like it much. To be honest, maybe I can keep it. So basically, I mean, on this open edge, we only have high and ultra, but I know on the final release, we're gonna have low, medium.
And probably since, you know, it also shows the individual settings.
Yeah.
A custom one where you can tweak.
Yeah, that's an important one.
But yeah, you know when you have... When you have one of these guns and you're just like, yeah, I know the monsters are gonna come from this door over here, and you're just firing it. It really is like that scene in Predator where, you know, they lose their mind and they're like just firing into the jungle and mowing everything down with the Predator's long gun.
Yeah, I remember that. So that's a nice one. This is so easy. Now it is super easy. I think once you get
a hang of the meta, but we were talking about that a few days ago, right? That now it feels like super easy. But the question, of course, is will it stay so super easy on the third and fourth floor?
That's an interesting question.
Because we don't know yet either, because the dev build also doesn't have four floors yet.
No, but also the meta progression that in the future you will have it. So, so that
yeah, I remember somebody in the 15th century. Like, ideally, a really good player should be able to get to the bottom. The core.
The core.
Because obviously there's not really a bottom of a station in space.
Yeah.
But yeah, to the core of the station without meta upgrades. But that should be only for really good players.
We made it.
Let's see.
Nice.
Oh, we actually already have the next zero upgrade machine here.
Of course.
But we don't have enough food.
The crystal shard, maybe it could be interesting to check.
Oh, right.
Just in case you
always
have
check this first. Yes. What do we have?
Diamonds, okay. Okay. I mean, you can keep it. You don't have to spend it.
Do they refresh after we move?
Yes.
Okay, then I don't think I'll spend it here because none of these were super appealing. Like the 20% speed on all actions is okay.
I mean, it's nice. I mean, I like as well the speed of the bot, the crystal.
Yeah, but it wasn't move speed, it was just
no.
The action speed.
Yeah, I know, I'm just seeing the one of the upgrades you have. Is it a bot? Oh, now you can start enjoying the flamethrower.
Yes, indeed. Probably right on top of them, or should I put the flamethrowers
here,
here
the
and
jelly
fire?
Here the jelly.
Yeah. Where's the jelly?
The second.
No, that was... Ah, shit. Oh, well.
Now jelly there. Yes.
I wish the range... Well, I guess the range upgrades.
It will upgrade. Yeah.
And,
also, can you turn up the voice of you guys more compared to the games? I struggle to understand you. Yes, we can upgrade. I will do it in a moment.
Yeah, let's move a little to...
It's because right now you pause the game. If you don't do that, it's not gonna be paused. This one. Now should be better. And coming back to the game.
Will new invites be sent? I think at this point we're not sending more invites. Because it's pretty much...
Late.
It's pretty late. I'm not sure. I was about to say halfway over, but I don't think that's accurate.
No, a bit more halfway. I think if nothing happens, tomorrow we should have a blog post, and then there we will set up, we will announce the end date of the OpenDev. I mean, we should be able to say now anyways, but just in case, let's keep it for tomorrow.
Let's just say you should maybe be playing this weekend.
Yeah, just play this weekend.
More industry or science?
No, science, because we'll have...
We only
48.
Have the one.
We'll have good industry.
Well, I guess this one is gonna be easy with only the one spawner.
Yeah, I normally tend to leave a bit to see how it works.
Actually, yeah, let's see if it's...
Yeah, it's because I like to see if it's efficient, the defense, or not. Because that's a way testing. And also a good opportunity to the Taurus to get level 2. I think the spider blocked the frame power point. That's why there's a bunch of minions that... Oh, no. It's because 5 seconds later the web... get trapped the turret, it's go down. That's why.
Now the jellyfire already has enough range to cover the door. Good.
Oh, it's super.
And sorry for putting the wrong.
Ah no,
turret there.
No worries.
But I maybe it'll distract them. I don't remember who it was, but I was as I was listening to streamers on the side while working. There was one who actually was. Maybe it was Kiri. Who was like, yeah, let's just put a defensive booster here, so they attack that one instead of the actual damage turrets.
Okay.
Though I'm not sure how efficient that is. It would probably be more efficient to put the the basic turret there.
Should we turn on here the lights? Because it's a good spot, this generator. There is no enemies. We need to wait for opening this for the other side. Should we spend the money, the crystal dust?
I'll leave that up to you.
Yes.
I decide.
Then, more production! Woohoo! What will be our games without the production? Also, I don't know if you have seen it, we bought on devices for Blaze that you slow enemies on him. So we're gonna be a bit powerful.
And Jaren saying, finished the OpenDev yesterday, I loved it. Yeah, that's great to hear that you enjoyed it, because obviously,
that's important.
With it, I was about to say, obviously with, the first time we let players play we're always super nervous because there's always that small chance that players get their hands on it and try it for the first time and
don't like it
and we realize, oh no, we were so caught up in our idea of the game, we didn't realize what the game actually is.
Yeah. Looks that.
That one little bug. It's always that one little bug, isn't it?
Yep.
Yep, here my blunder starts. It's coming back at us.
No, you just need to put the flame on, that's it. Easy. Also, the flame here is
needs
to be upgraded.
But it's more like, you know, if we had the two flamers here and the jelly here, then you probably wouldn't have had to build it now.
Yes, maybe, but it's okay. You can upgrade the turret someplace. Yes, that one.
Oh. No, that one can't be upgraded.
Not yet, but maybe the jelly.
The jelly, yes. Most importantly, this is the only door we have left, I think.
Yeah.
Oh no, there's another one up there.
Yeah, but it's fine. Oh, research. That's nice. We're gonna spend
Let's see.
Ooh. It's not a bad idea, the Vasitor level 2 or the refresh.
We also have the Tesla ball.
So, do you want a variety of tires or do you want to have full fire?
Yeah, that's my question is the flamethrower good enough to manage the bots on the second level?
Yes.
Then let's go for the improved.
Hey, good afternoon, Dr. Kane. So I'm feeling like an alchemist today.
Oh.
Managed to make a powdered seasoning that tastes like mojito, a delicious Brazilian fish stew. So I managed to make a grilled fish that toasted the stew.
Wow.
Where is my tupper? Where is my tupper? Can even put another flame here on the corner.
You know, I'm also just thinking, I should probably just actually show off Blaze's skill.
Ah, yeah, the ultimate.
Because that instantly completed the wave.
Yeah.
So you were saying flame here?
Or a basic turret, whatever you want.
How expensive is the flame?
Flame is fine.
3? Yeah, flame is fine. It's not that much more expensive.
No!
Again, the wrong one.
No? You put the flame?
Oh, no.
It's because you see the
little thing.
One.
We don't have a support tower in here, do we? Yeah. Oh no, back there. Ah, yeah. I saw the shield and was like, oh no, it's the wrong one again.
Sorry. Yeah, I put it there.
Yeah.
In purpose.
Yeah, yours, unlike mine, was planned.
Yeah, it was planned. Oops, sorry. Oh yeah, this is the second level, let's say.
Yep.
What do we have here? Oh yes. Time boost. Another research, Jesus Christ.
And there's a chest over there as well.
I think we're gonna spam a lot of industry or food.
Heavy Gatling. I'm not sure replacing one of Blaze's guns with a heavy Gatling.
So we got more industry.
Is it still worth it at 10?
Why not? Or maybe more food? It could be interesting. So in case we have more weapons or hero upgrades.
Yeah,
could
maybe.
Interesting.
Also, speaking of hero upgrades, I think we do have the hero upgrade machine where the crystal is now.
Yeah,
so maybe we should check if there's anything we should get.
Yeah, but I'm just tenting first on this. Industry shall always go.
Always industry. Yeah, I mean, the nice thing with industry, of course, is also that it kind of never goes to waste.
No.
Because, you know, food or science, you need to find the machine, but you always have turrets, but somewhere.
I'm gonna have another one here, so it's impossible that they can. It's gonna be impossible for them.
Sadly, we can't stack it the same way we could stack the new Rostan modules back
but
in.
But now I have the time to do my upgrade.
I think you might have seen it on stream with Jordan when we stack multiple new Rostan modules in one room.
Yeah, I think so.
There's something like, you know, minus 30% speed when they're fully upgraded, and when you put like 3 of them in there. They basically don't move at all anymore.
Now you can decide and see the hero upgrades.
Return damage. No. Ah, see now.
Talking about this.
This is more interesting because I was saying, we were talking earlier and I was saying like, yeah, you know, the whole, take damage, deal more damage is interesting if you had a way to heal. There's the way to heal. So now you might actually be able to take some damage.
Yep.
Where's the remaining doors? Right, it's all of the power doors now.
Mm-hmm.
Should we open the connecting door first or one of the others?
Yeah, you can open the connector. It's a free industry because it's protected. Well,
speaking of free industry, it's only 1 point, but it's still 1 point.
Still 1 point.
I mean, 1 point is. 1 point feels so little when you've played, you know, Humankind and stuff, but here, 1 point, that's a third of a turret.
Yeah, now that we have a basic level, the basic turret level 2, now is much powerful. Especially in, talking about bots.
Oh, wait. The only you could see here the difference between the damage types, because I'm pretty sure it took 2 shots of the flame weapon and only 1 of the electrical weapon.
Yeah, the only problem is
maybe railgun? That's a charge weapon, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so.
Nope.
The only problem is like here you don't have a good spots for defending position, so maybe a basic turret there.
Okay. What's the turret we have with the best range? Probably the basic turret.
No, nothing. It's gonna be too long. You are.
This is one where we would have needed the Tesla.
Yeah, include a basic turret there, or a blaze, whatever you want.
It could be a blaze because it's right next to the first one.
Yep. And you can just defend. Then you can do the next wave because you play too strong compared with me, so let's do it.
I guess it was because we did research or something.
Yeah, I think so. Just leave them coming a bit so they
let's stand over here and
I mean just a bit.
Yeah, of course some of them are ranged and we do need to shoot the range.
Have a generator
back
there.
Oh no.
Then maybe it's worth it the basic turret there that we mentioned before. Yeah, it's gonna be worth it that basic turret there. Especially now that it's level 2. Ooh, the destroyer. It's super powerful.
God.
Oh, the other. There is a rolling queen there in the mission.
Hit the wrong button.
You can teleport it.
You know, I actually hit RB instead of.
Two of the generators are with the rolling queen, so they're getting destroyed, both of them.
Yeah, but I accidentally hit the right button instead of right trigger as I was trying to get over there.
Oh. I just get nervous, like, oh, defend him!
What's the other one? Damn it! Tiny little bug over there, probably.
Yeah, that's why I was like,
Yep, of course, one nibbler.
You can just keep going if you want.
No upgrades here.
Oh, we can have a basic turret there.
Do the defense ones actually even get experience yet?
What do you mean?
Because, you know, the jelly fires affect enemies. So obviously they might get experience when an enemy they're affecting. Right?
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not sure if we've set up like support turrets that are buff turrets for experience yet.
Not for experience.
Because obviously they're not involved in killing any enemies. All right, that's the right.
You can just go up if you want.
I kinda don't want to because you know this defense is kind of bad.
Yeah, it's a bit risky. I'm not gonna say no.
I'd much rather check over here and pray that maybe this is a dead end and we can focus up there.
Okay, it's a quite nice place. I actually prefer that to the Magnum, but that's me.
I don't know why
I say light sparker, but I think it's
light weapon type, light and heavy, like one-handed and two-handed.
Ah, I don't know why my head was.
But shouldn't the fire damage weapon be red? That's what confused me.
Yeah, I think it's a bug.
But yeah, I also, you know, this is, you know, very nice to just hose them down, so to speak.
A nice weapon.
Oh.
So I think you can put jelly.
Jelly here, and then the turret
flying
over here.
And basic, I will say.
Where's the second jelly?
I just know my heart. Oh. Yes, and a basic turret. And I think that's okay. More or less.
But obviously we need to hang out over
here
because...
and also maybe place Blaze in another position because...
Where even is he right now?
I think you can put it... Well, you can just leave it there if you want. But I think...
He's kind of defending the science generator, I guess.
Yeah. We're going really. I mean, if you need it, you can just play basic tarot because we have 50.
Come on, where's the heal bot? Kill the healbot!
The healbot! Kill it!
I think it's okay.
Yeah, I remember in one of the early builds, I think the heal rate was much higher or something.
Yeah.
Or maybe the tankiness of the... Wait, we already voted on that, right?
They made it
Rex? What was the winner of the world?
Yeah,
right?
Rex.
I think they used to be...
It's called...
Oh my god!
Cold Wielder. Oh,
used to be much tankier or something, mm-hmm. And you know, I had this situation where I couldn't get to the healbot because I couldn't shoot through the Rexes in front of it, and it was healing so fast.
Ah, yeah. Are any Song of Dungeons of Lilith going to be in this game? I wouldn't count with it. It's just that.
Yeah, there. Oh, actually, but
that's much better, yeah.
Don't die! Yeah, we did lose the generator here because
maybe it's time for me to.
It's time for you to save us.
No, just increase a bit the defenses.
But the thing is, where? Ah, yeah, there's, I guess, a couple of spots here, but... How did none of these level up? Ah, the Jellyfire leveled up, I guess, but...
Maybe because they got a destroyer, maybe. That could increase a bit of difficulty.
Love the chasm there, the aesthetic of this is so dang good. Yeah, it looks great. I remember when we first showed some trailers, we had a lot of people like, oh... I don't know about the new look, you know, I love the pixel art in Dungeon of the Endless, and now, you know, people are actually playing it and they're like, oh no, this actually looks amazing!
Yeah.
It's like, sometimes I was sitting there like, thinking, I wasn't saying it because it would have, you know, come across as rude probably, but was just thinking like, no guys, trust our art team, they know what they're doing.
Yeah. Where do I need to go? What is the... Ah, I just saw it. We didn't investigate the dark room, well, the enemy room of the bots.
Yep.
So probably the switch is there.
There's the switch in there, probably, yeah.
Come on. Really? Look at it.
Yep. There's the switch. Unlike the Steam Deck, which nobody can catch. No, I think they've actually started shipping quite a few of them.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I didn't know.
I think they've picked up the pace with the shipping now. Because, you know, the whole chip shortage has gotten better.
The
Steam Deck. I've actually been thinking about getting one, but of course, they still wasn't pre-order, so waiting for them. Yeah. Well, hi Ozone, welcome to the stream. I see first time chat. Excited for Humankind to come to Xbox. Are you satisfied with the control will work? I can't answer that because I personally haven't tried them yet, and I also haven't talked to the team yet about the controller controls. So I don't know what they're like yet.
I'm just gonna go for double or nothing.
You know, I was about to say what how are you going for double or nothing when you didn't find a the device?
Because it triggered a wave.
No, what I mean is that, you know, there's the double or nothing device that gives you like the plus 100% damage, but you also take double damage or something like that.
Ah, yeah, I actually love that one. Really, you don't get the... I'm gonna just bite here.
Maybe you should take a peek into the room at the bottom where the monsters are coming from, just in case there's like a chest full of goodies.
Yeah, that could be actually nice.
Nope.
But I want...
No chests, just bugs.
It's okay. I have everything under control.
I mean, the good thing is that, you know, with Bunker you can do risky shit like that now because she heals.
Yep, that's true. We make it easy.
Yeah, for him it's easy. I am the kind of person who needs to play on too easy.
I'm excited for Humankind on Xbox.
Yeah, some games are hit or miss with the controller. Yes, I agree. Can be very difficult. Especially sometimes when you get strategy games and they're just like, yeah, we just mapped the mouse cursor to the stick. I remember I played Command & Conquer on the N64 back then because I couldn't get it on PC.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like, you know, a remaster of the first one.
Okay.
After the third one had come out. And it was atrocious. trying to control a mouse cursor with a
It's not the
with the stick is already bad enough. But also, have you ever held an N64 controller?
No.
The stick didn't have the nice rubber coating of like the modern Xbox and PlayStation controllers. It was like hard gray plastic, so it was uncomfortable to use. Of course, industry.
Yeah, it's not a good spot, actually. So I think you can have jelly plain and basic. The words. No, jelly here.
Jelly in the middle.
Mm-hmm. Okay. The fourth one. No.
Here the flame. And here. The basic over there or the other.
No. Flame over there. There is nothing here. Yeah. I think so. For me, it's a good spot. But
I'm not sure. I'm afraid they'll move, you know, around the corner here, just outside of the range.
Okay, then just go, just put whatever you want. It's your turn. I'm not gonna interfere.
Yeah, we got. I mean, it's hard to see, but like the range here on the flame.
Yeah, it's there's, a bit,
There's space for them to just walk past it without it shooting.
Yeah.
And then it'll never level up to get more range.
But you will put a basic turret here for sure.
Yeah, that's definitely yes.
Because they may attack the generator.
And then they'll come from other directions. Possibly as well.
Yeah,
I'm actually going to use this one because it's further from the generator.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, it's
nice. Yeah. First you need to. Maybe it would be nice if we can get an AMP on the research. Hopefully you get an EMP. Otherwise, I will refresh it. Ah,
there it
EMP.
Is. The
but first, you should place the defenses here. There's nothing. Yeah,
I think it's fine because we have
the
weapon.
But
actually,
Blaze.
Yeah, I was about to say, Blaze is not not following us. It was still on, you know, hang back and wait.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this you are over. It's everything under control.
That's a way bigger wave than I was expecting.
Yeah, that's true. It's more than I expected. But at least now.
But at least now we have more Daka.
Daka.
And we also have
Daka. No.
more jelly, I guess.
Yeah.
And more fire.
You can put another basic one there if you want in the upper part.
Yeah, we.
It's because an EMP. I don't think it's gonna cover. It's gonna happen the same problem.
Yeah. But I was thinking. Do we need it here, or would we rather put it in here?
I mean, here...
Because we have three doors leading into this room.
No, but here, for example, I will put an EMP here, for sure.
Bottom now. Bottom.
And maybe... A basic there, because... Or not. Basic, yeah.
Basic covers the whole
there thing, is nothing else you can do there.
But there's actually another door here. So should we go this way first, I guess?
Yeah. Why not?
You know, we have more turrets along the way. Ooh,
I will take it now.
Let me first grab some
more dust. Yeah, so you can just leave Blaze here and take a bunker to the other room. So you have four. There's a free path for the crystal.
Oh, of course you need to destroy it.
It's okay. You have everything under control. Osonis is saying like this looks cool, mix of tower defense and a smash TV. Smash TV?
Smash TV, I think it was a game, but I'm sure.
I've never played that one, so I cannot say
that. But the title seems familiar. Oh,
it's the first time we do it.
Finished really short.
But now you need to go for there to say to the first of the
day. Oh, wait, oh, it follows the.
No,
it follows the closest hero, doesn't it?
No,
it probably follows. Yeah. She was stuck on the wall. Yeah, she was trying to get to Blaze and was walking into the wall.
But you need to tell them to go back to the other side, otherwise it's gonna just not. No, he can't move along.
Did we take that much damage on the last floor, or was that from drilling the shark?
I think it was the mix, but on the first floor. Hello, Lucius! When is this available? Now it's an open dev, so final release, you don't know.
Honestly, I don't know either because I don't remember right now. I know we probably have it written down somewhere, but I don't remember.
Did we?
I mean, surely there's some plan at least within like, you know, oh, this month or something like that. Maybe not a specific day.
Yes.
But like, you know.
Yes, but we cannot say that.
Game looks like a lot of fun. Yeah, it definitely is. It can be a bit overwhelming when you're bad at it, like I am.
Okay, you're okay. Should we open before moving the curse? Nah, yes, more risk. Yes. Always more risk. It's okay. Everything under control.
At least you have the electrical weapon. Imagine if you didn't have one.
I wanted to include this one here, but the point is... Here is what we... Can I put something? No, I cannot.
Damn it.
Damn it. Then it's a bit more tricky, but...
But of course, you know, that's the locked door, which means that this is probably the way we need to go anyway.
Yep. So I'm not sure if I... Yeah, I'm gonna just put the jelly, so... As soon as you get level 2, it should be okay. And you will say... Yeah, it's safe.
I was gonna ask, will this be multiplayer? Yes, there will be multiplayer release where... Of course, right now you can see that we're switching between the heroes in single player. In multiplayer, everybody will control one hero. Mm-hmm. Which is also why the heroes now don't stay dead if you know, screw up and die.
Yeah.
Because that wouldn't be fun, being the person who no longer gets to play.
Yeah, it wouldn't be fun.
I mean, I guess, you know, you always have the option of just talking smack while everybody else is playing.
I love the EMPs. Like, look at the damage. Or not.
I think it has a long recoil.
Yeah, it is.
It had like a massive burst, but like the DPS was like 1 damage per second or something because it's such a slow recharge.
I do have everything on control.
And where's...
You're gonna still open doors if you want.
Let's check over here.
Yeah, should
be okay. Oh, nice. There's another locked door. So now I'm not entirely sure which one is the way forward.
Ooh, and now you can upgrade.
What do we have?
Ooh.
50 for 25.
28. And the other hero? Is it worth 28 or 28?
First thing, let's see. Even more bonus damage for lost HP.
Ooh, so... I think we can just push it up great place. Hopefully.
Yeah, because also it's a lot cheaper here.
Yeah. You can refresh it if you want.
I think we have enough signs to. 40% max HP is not nothing.
Well, it's okay, 40%. Is that or you refresh?
No, I think the 40% HP is.
It's flat, 40%, so it's nice.
Yeah, it's gonna make him a lot more survivable. Specifically, 40% more survivable.
Oh, come on. The place of turrets is horrible. It's horrible.
Of course, everything's a dark room here as well. Oh, also, we have... we already have a device, right?
Yes, you can put it, actually. Yeah, it's really nice.
We already have...
device. You can
turn on
the light. That's what I was thinking.
I know, but also we need to check the upgrades.
Yeah,
so
put here an EMP if you're not gonna have any of your defenses. Yeah, so everything going into a funnel.
You know, just as it should be.
More dagger than you want to speak.
Exactly.
Just look at the speed of the target.
I once read that, you know, they bought I think it was a Russian fighter jet that had also a Gatling 5 gun for the times when you still need the. Apparently, there is still situations where they want to direct fire instead of, you know, just firing themselves. Mm-hmm. But apparently, that thing had so much recoil that every time after they tested it and they landed, they realized all of the position lights and everything on the jet were broken.
Okay.
Because the Gatling just shook the plane so hard, and it's like apparently slowed down the plane when they were shooting because it had so much recoil. I was like, Maybe you went overboard there.
Maybe.
I mean, I guess we can check what the other one is we have. Increases damage of it. Both of them are four.
Yeah.
Sticking together. So
you can open the door if you want. The bottom one.
Yeah, I guess.
Why not?
See, this is more appealing with the way we've been playing right now.
Yeah.
Medkid.
Ah! But that's for Blaze.
Yeah, I was about to say, this is one I really want on Blaze, actually.
You can just call into bomb. It's
true.
Sorry, it's just my way of like not moving.
But this also feels like one that might be useful since we keep them split most of the time.
Yeah.
But since right now we have the UI glitch where we don't see the price,
I think it's 9 or something like
that. Yeah, but still, let's first buy the important one. And then we buy the other one.
Do you want to buy it?
I think, you know, we're fine on the medkits.
Okay.
Also, I forgot. Again, check the upgrades. Oh, wait, actually. Let's switch.
Get the knife. Put it here. Here is.
Wait,
that's
here?
Good. Yeah, it's okay.
Or more over here in the door.
I think over here in the door should be okay because you have the support of the turret. And also, Oscar is asking, each character have separate abilities, strengths, and weaknesses. Yes, they have separate legacy tributes, passive and special ability and ultimate. But they don't have like strength, weaknesses, the heroes. The family of monsters, they have weaknesses and strengths. For example, the bots, these ones, are more weak against electric damage. And they are...
I think the damage type they're resistant against is actually
light.
Not in the open dev.
Yeah, it is.
I think there's like one or two damage that I can have. But like, no, none of the turrets.
No, yes, the turrets have to resist.
It's electric
damage.
Yeah, I'd say the type they're resistant against.
Resistant in the light, yeah.
Yeah,
sorry.
And the light damage, we don't have any of the light turrets in yet. And I think there's only like one pistol.
The fission is so bad.
And, no, the fission MG is... No, that's... It's this one, it's the fission MG. And look at the color, that's not light damage.
Is that the fission MG?
Yes.
No,
that's the fission MG, we picked it up earlier.
Yeah.
Like
okay.
We have the I don't remember the name, but the light damage sniper,
okay.
I think, is in
okay,
the game.
Okay, for me that's the fission MG.
No, this is the fission MG.
Okay.
At least it said earlier when we picked it up that it's the fission MG.
I'm gonna charge you.
But the important thing is we have one light damage type weapon on the heavy and on the light weapons, I think.
Mm-hmm.
But that's all, so you're not super likely to find them, I guess.
I think you can keep it or refresh it if you want. You can keep it. Maybe the speed
really
if you want to spend it. Otherwise, you can.
The question I have, I'm never sure. 20% speed on all crystal actions. Does that include walking?
I'm not sure. I haven't tried
because
that.
I think it's only the ones, you know, how quickly the circle fills when it does something,
mm-hmm.
not how quickly it moves.
But that's an action.
Yeah, but usually, you know, it's while it's moving that I have the biggest problems.
No, I mean, you can put it for the final door, is fine.
But yeah, let's actually get it because we have two shorts and that's. Fine, because
but
we're probably going to find another one.
The spanning
right?
Actually is from.
Oh wait, actually yes. I was about to say we are out of doors up here, so I guess we do need to
open.
Which one has the best turret placement next to it? None of them are good. I guess this one at least has two.
The other one is actually a good spot.
Oh wait, there's another door here. Yes.
Yes.
But obviously this one is obviously a dead end.
Oh, crystal shard just nearby. It's fine. It's wonderful.
I mean, it's just really. Yeah, I mean,
just get it. We can wait to see if
we can
how speed it.
I can just stand here now and.
No, I think maybe the walking a bit. Yeah, I think it's including the walking.
But yeah, we can just stand here and wait for it to drill, and then it'll come back, and we slot it back in.
Yeah,
and it's fine.
Yeah, that's sick. You can just already do it. There's nothing coming.
If only we had opened that door first.
You should.
Oh right. Yeah, me too.
Yes, that's it. Otherwise, it's not gonna happen.
But yeah, here you really notice that it's quicker.
Mm-hmm. That's it. Easy.
Did that refresh? Sadly, no.
No,
right?
No. You can only spend one.
Yeah, I wasn't sure if
district.
It. if it refreshes if you do this or if it's tied to the slot, not to the slotting. Get what I mean?
Yeah. Get you.
Yeah.
We are really bad luck for the generator because I wanted science.
But at least, you know, at least it's not a monster spawner.
wait, the robot has a warrant. A warrant? A warrant.
The a warrant is, you know, a license to arrest somebody or, you know, to come into their house to... So a long range medium piercing. I think that's the one she already has, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so. You should put some defenses there, yeah.
Yeah, we don't have many spots here. 2, 3... Ah, no, there's another one here.
So I would say AMP at 2 and 2 basic turrets. Oh.
EMP right here?
Yeah, and 2 basic turrets.
And then here's the basic, right?
Because it's level 2, so maybe it will maintain the situation. Especially if they upgrade to level 2.
And if not, we're nearby to help out.
Yeah, yeah, you're gonna stay there, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, there's no other doors. We still haven't found the switch.
Actually, you can maybe upgrade some turrets with the bunker, maybe there.
Oh, true. They might have...
Maybe the ones here.
In here. The bottom.
Maybe. Oh, no. Okay. They're fine. Oh. Aye, aye. Well, now, way to testing the defenses.
Yep, just gonna, you know, stand over here near the crystal and see if anything comes out of the room down there.
I normally tend to be, like, nearby the room to see how efficient I am, but that's just me.
I mean, we'll see if they come out of the door or not.
Yeah.
Also, we'll see it on the map, that
Yeah, that's the... look, yeah. Maybe you
right,
can put the EMP there.
It's no longer cold to have the map.
Or another basic turret there. On the door. Not the...
I was just momentarily confused because of the little red dot next to Blaze on the map. Like, I thought there was like a little enemy, but no, I guess that's part of the thing.
Yeah,
oh yeah, we definitely need another...
basic door? Under the door? Or an EMP, whatever you
want. Is the EMP wide enough?
Yeah. Oop.
Maybe not be in the menu while getting shot?
I mean, you can.
Yeah, but you know. I'd rather not be shot.
Yeah, I understand that feeling. You can upgrade the turret as well.
Yes.
You're gonna make it to the last door.
Where? Oh, right, there's that room. That's why they...
So this room is gonna give you a switch.
This should be the switch because it's the last one that... Yeah, there it is.
Perfect. Maximize.
Ah, and also, it's a shortcut for the crystal.
Yep.
Nice. We think this is. No, wait, there's the spawn point down here.
It's okay.
Well.
If you make it past, it's okay. Leave the character here and can manage a bunker.
Yeah, I was thinking, you know, bunker definitely has the. Better gun against these guys.
Yeah, that's what you're gonna
wait.
Know.
The door's here.
Yep. Or the final door. Okay. So I will say here a jelly or a EMP, whatever you. No, it's because you cannot do it.
Let me just check.
Oh, 14 seconds.
The splatter gun is. Isn't the splatter gun the one that's like absurdly powerful when you're close to the enemy?
I would say here and an EMP.
Here?
Yeah, it's because right now you don't have defenses and you have 2 new spots. So you're gonna be overwhelmed a bit.
Oh, no, wait, I need to head back to the crystal because, you know, up here they kept coming out of that.
Okay.
Down here seems to be fine now, but there.
Yeah, Blaze is gonna suffer a bit.
I mean, I can leave her here and move Blaze away.
Yeah.
But the important thing is we need a hero down there because the turrets are insufficient.
Yeah. We have a huge industry.
Yeah, we'll place some turrets over here in a moment. When it's not wave time.
You have all the enemies that is running away.
Oh no! Hey guys, It's missile time. Come on.
I mean, not worth it with your double take damage. But you can heal yourself.
I underestimate how much the missiles really slow him down and how long it lasts to fire them.
You need to just prepare the defenses for the last door and that's it.
Well, also I meant to, where
EMP
is it?
There. No, it's not worth it.
This is a downgrade, this is also a downgrade. Okay.
Yeah, especially with the double damage, you're gonna go closer because that's a short range close. Also,
yeah, where to place it? Probably
EMP
here.
You can have a couple of basic torres if you want. There.
Scatter them around here somewhere, I guess. One here, one over there.
It's
maybe.
Because they're gonna come here, because the crystal is going to be here.
True. Yeah, but they're also coming, gonna come out of that door,
it's
but
okay.
I guess this is the more important spot.
It's okay, you don't need more. I think that's okay.
Well, I do want to smash the stuff up here. Because that might still be a little bit of extra resources.
You can just leave Blaze here and just get with
this. I'm gonna leave him somewhere where he's slightly protected from the...
Bye-bye.
Oh, shit, too slow. Yeah, I was too slow. This is why I should leave it to you, because
you're
better at this.
Yeah, it's been a while actually since I played, so yeah. Sorry. But now we can have a 3-hero mode.
Ah, true, we did make it to the second floor.
Unloading game. Is it a crash? Is it a crash?
It could be.
It could be a crash.
Generally, you know, we recommend rebooting the game after every run anyway.
Yeah.
Because it's not optimized yet, and there are some performance issues when it runs for a long time.
Mm. So even though it's a screen, it's just we're opening the game.
Yeah, we're just relaunching the game.
Actually, it's gonna be strange on 3-hero because I tend to play 3-hero modes on keyboard. So now it's gonna be strange for me on here.
You'll manage. Oh no, it still says locked. Didn't save it.
No. You have to. Just for people, because I saw people, you have a wonderful, like, on this side. Unlock this. To unlock, you have to activate the Y. And that's it. Because I see some people confusing.
And no subluses. This has nothing at all to do with Denuvo.
No.
It's a garbage cleanup issue that hasn't been optimized yet, where, you know, the old data that is not needed anymore stays in the memory.
Yes, why not? Look good.
It's the first time I see, you know, one of the locked doors right next to where you start.
Really?
Never happened to me before.
Yeah, no, it's nice. So do have this challenge of only have basic turret. Maybe too risky.
Then it wouldn't need to be you playing the whole time,
no.
I think.
We already said no! We said no! The never end.
But I think, you know, in this case, he is joking.
Yeah.
Even if I think half of the smiley went missing, I think that's supposed to be, you know, a winking face or something at the end there.
Yeah, that's true. Uh-huh.
But yeah, we have seen the complaints. We have forwarded the complaints. Now it is out of our hands. We can only, you know, update you whenever a decision has been made.
I'm gonna leave here this one. This is what I do, I just micromanage many heroes, so it's like, yeah, you wanna stay there. And it's... Did I miss... no, the enemy is here, I was thinking like, what? The enemy is one of the spots? It's super confused, actually. I don't like this turn. But it's better than nothing.
Also, you know, I do think the artist did a really good job on the spawner for the bugs. Because it looks awful. It's exactly what you'd want. You know, it looks awful in the best possible way, is what I'm saying. Like a plague marine or something like that.
Let's see what's going on. Oh, if you were not shooting from it. Let's see here. Let's see how.
Released it? Not yet, no. Sorry. Well, if you want to play, well, if you had signed up, you might have gotten an invitation to play the OpenDev, and if not, you'll have to be a bit more patient. There may be other chances to try it before release. We can't talk about that yet. Just as we can't really talk about the release date yet. I think you can upgrade the jump.
Yeah, I was thinking about the map, but yeah, I'm not gonna open that one. Because maybe they decide to... When I was good. Okay. Run. Oh, yes, research. Yes. Give me. I'm just going super fast, I don't know why.
Because you're good at the game, unlike me.
Nah, it's not that. Give it to me. Help.
Maybe you want to make up for the lost time of me screwing up the last run. You're motivated to win at least one run per stream.
Yes. It's like, now I need to win.
But you have a mighty need.
Yeah. It's a need. Spanish Inquisition, you know? We need to win always. Ah! Final door. Easy.
Well, intermediate door. The final door is a bit more impressive.
I mean, yeah, intermediate. By the way, should I...
Let me play a bit while it's still manageable for me. I should leave the second floor to you because I clearly demonstrated that I'm not equipped for the second floor.
You just need some more hours.
Yeah, definitely.
That's it.
But I don't have the hours yet. Oh, come on, there's probably a spawner in here, isn't there?
Yes, it is. You have a lot of things there.
Ah, yeah, there it is.
So, yeah, you need a jelly there or something, or you're gonna just leave the emptiness.
Well, I was gonna
leave it.
Fall back closer to where that is, because nothing here is... I guess the merchant.
I mean, it's okay, you can just leave the merchant.
Yeah, I don't think there's really... Didn't see what he had on. Alright.
Yes. Rip merchant, exactly.
Some of you are going to die, but it's a sacrifice I'm willing to make.
Now you have the help of the set.
It was too early.
I did well on
I miss the sparkler already. Not even for the fire damage, just for the fire rate. This, I guess, place is taking care of it.
Yeah, I just leave it in a good hands. Oh, one damage, one HP damage on the
person. Sadly, the merchant doesn't drop his items, right?
Rip.
Well, I guess, you know, it has to be that way because otherwise our players would always kill the merchant.
I would kill the merchant. Ooh. Yes, take it. Well, not with this one. Actually, is there a queen or something on the map?
Yes.
Oh,
yeah, up there.
You can just swap two place. No, you need to level Kirby. Yeah.
Yeah, you need to.
The one. Nice.
Oh, come on, the firing rate is slow on this
gun.
That's
why you should get the other weapon with this one.
And it's not even strong enough to kill them in one shot.
You're gonna repair maybe the turret.
Yeah, if I ever get close enough without the mods just being there. Come on.
It's okay. You have the mini kits.
But I guess, you know.
Maybe you will make it to the queen.
I guess the pro strat would now be just sit here until the turret levels up.
that could be.
But that would not be an interesting stream.
No, you should. Maybe one day you make it to the queen.
But I think our VIPs did say that, you know, for the heroes, if you get a good spawn where it's easily defensible, you just stand there and you kill monsters until it's done.
Yeah.
And then, you know, you have all the hero level ups you will ever need.
Yeah, like I say, like pro farm stats, strats. Exactly. That's exactly what it's trying to do.
Oh, wait. Is this door open?
No, but don't open it.
You know, if it had been open, I would have walked through.
No, it's like, but don't open it, please.
Where was blade later. Left? Somewhere over here?
Yeah, over there, yeah, it's fine. Yeah, it's fine there.
No, wait, actually, we wanted to take blades down to the
true.
Gun.
Yeah, and then you can teleport there. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Two people DM us on Twitch. What's happening? People, wait, you can just write
where,
here.
Where did we leave the gun?
here, I think, yeah. Or no.
No, no, I think it is somewhere where a bunker
yes,
was hanging around.
Yeah, done. I forget about that.
There it is.
Yes. Nice. Oof. Okay, I thought it was like...
I mean, this is still...
Yeah, it's okay. You can teleport now to just avoid the walking.
It's, you know, it's a lot better fire rate for the hordes than this one is.
No, but, yeah. It's just put it here or something like that because it's a close range. So you put on the corner, maybe you don't have enough range.
I think the AI does swap the weapons in theory.
Yeah, but not as good.
But not as reliably as, you know, a player would.
And you have Wait, final door.
Where's? Oh, yeah, that's the only door left?
No, you can open this one, but then you need to go run for the other one. For the final door, because otherwise you're gonna trigger one wave. And we don't want that, because the defenses are not meant to that. Well, maybe you can hero upgrade now, because you have the space. Okay.
No.
Maybe check the other DPS. Okay, no? Ooh, yeah. Pistolero.
Oh, come on!
Nice. And you can do also the other one.
All right, we do have enough. Oh no, wrong button. that doesn't feel like an upgrade.
No, nothing. Run! Run for your life!
Actually, I just saw. Now, where do we actually need to reinforce the defense?
Leave it there. You can just stay here. Like, hold the door! Multiple doors. Actually. Ay, ay, ay.
Isn't regenerator under attack? What? Where?
It's okay. You can just leave it to die.
I mean,
no more doors.
There's no more doors anyway. Yeah, but I was wondering where, just in case it's... I guess it can't be risky for the crystal because the crystal's right there.
Yeah. So yeah, you cannot leave this black.
Oh wait, queen.
Yeah, the rolling queen. You can swap.
Nope.
Come on. Yes. You can now just prepare the defenses for the last door, and that's it. And we make it to the second. Easy. And maybe you can.
Oh wait.
No. Well,
let's just check if there's anything.
Maybe the EMP is not a bad idea. But before do that,
we should put some defense here, yeah.
Maybe just one, and you can stay there.
Which direction is here?
Yeah, you can stay there. Protecting. Maybe they don't come. Yeah, they come. Ah, yes, behind. Okay, in the bottom. So you.
Oh
can,
yeah, yes.
So now at least they can get some EXP experience. Does Queen have a special minimap icon? No,
but the circle is a lot bigger than the others.
Yeah, you can see the circle not moving it and
producing. Yeah, when there's a big red dot that occasionally spawns two little red dots that... Oh!
Don't abandon the research. Yeah.
I think now only the Queen is left.
As
where
you can
you
see, the queen, you can see clearly what it is.
Oh, let's just make sure.
Just one, right?
I was just repairing that one just in case, you know. Oh. No.
You have the medikit, it's okay.
Why use medikits if you can avoid it?
Well, yeah. You can try to avoid it.
Ah, she's running into blaze. Excellent.
Nice. So let's prepare the final door. For you to survive.
Yeah, it's over here, right?
Nope. Ah, yeah. Sorry, I don't know why I said no. So yeah.
Yeah, I was not sure either.
So you can have a couple of basic if you want, or yeah, just one is fine. Just one, because you have the three heroes. That's it, you can just go. And also you can, on the wheel, you can say like, all follow me on the wheel, no? On the bottom.
Ah, right.
And you can just... That's it. Well, you should teleport,
guess,
to the crystal.
Yeah, teleport here. And
the good thing is like, if you have the order or follow me, all the heroes
everybody
will teleport.
Right?
Yeah. So that's just really nice, actually. I think it should have a clear indication, because when she's in the other part of the map, all I see is never ending spawning moving at me.
Yeah, yeah. No, we've already seen the feedback that
yeah,
it, says it lacks a certain sense of urgency, but not just on the one hand because, you know, the interface doesn't make it look super threatening, on the other hand because, like, spawning two mobs isn't super threatening in a wave of like 40 mobs.
Yeah. I should repair that for putting the bunker. I'm gonna stay here. It's okay, so you can see.
I'm just chilling back here, I guess.
Yeah, just leave the DPS on the front line. I think you didn't get how the tank works, because the tank should be in the front,
well, the
not
thing
behind.
Is, the thing is, our tank probably has the least health of all of them right now.
No.
Too slow always on the ability.
Yeah. Like, open the whole door. Open it.
Oh, come on.
Just
quick upgrade. Damn it, Zed! She's doing it again!
I actually, not hating, but it's like, why you teleport everyone?
But yeah, I had that, was that on stream? That one time where, or maybe I was playing privately, you know, I was trying to move the crystal.
Okay.
And the hero that was said to follow me just decided to stay in that last room and keep shooting, and then she died. And I was like, in a completely different room, and was like, why aren't you following me?
Yeah. You can
go
ask,
ahead.
You can reply Sylvester's.
Yep. Let's see. I mean, Dota did the first special monster by it should differ. Yeah, I'm pretty sure they probably already have plans for that, but this, you know, this is still an early build, so it's not there yet. And as I say, you know, we've seen the feedback about the UI, but also very much about the thread, and they probably need to work on that, because, yeah. Oh no, she spawned two nibblers! How terrifying! And the suggestion some people had said about that, I think, was actually like, yeah, sure, she starts spawning like two nibblers, and then over time, her spawns get bigger and bigger. So that, you know, you can't wait forever to deal with her.
Also, well, you have more experience than me on Dota, but on Dota, I think, if I'm not mistaken, the special display is on the boss. It's not on all of the monsters, right? It's only on the bosses.
No, it's on. There's a couple of special monsters. Like, there's the boss that's in, like, the, what's it called, Chimera Keeper.
Yeah.
That's, you know, the stationary one that buffs all the monsters.
Yeah.
But I think there's also special icons on the one that runs around and opens doors.
Ah, okay.
And
I don't remember it.
What was the other one? I think there was another one. Arcalis, yes, my mind went there, and then I was like, no, don't have the queen spawning more queens, so it just, you know, keeps multiplying. Yeah, the Rhino, that's the one I meant, the open doors, but I think there was another one. But I don't remember.
This is a terrible spot.
And as for the game difficulty, adjusting to the number of players, we're working on that. I'm not sure how much of it is implemented yet, but yes, it's supposed to scale the difficulty a little bit when you have three heroes compared to two.
Yeah, I think it's a 10%, if not mistaken.
Yeah, but 10% is probably not enough for you have 50% more gun.
No, I'm just saying that right now I think it's 10%. I'm not saying it's
so, yeah, we're still, you know, we're working on that. It's intended, but it will require some fine-tuning.
This is the only thing I hate when I'm not on the keyboard. It's like the control is not always swapping between all of them. Come on.
But yeah, because I think part of the difficulty of adjusting the between two and three heroes difficulty right now is also that from some feedback we got from the VIPs, and I think also from some of the OpenDev players, is that the heroes just get crazy powerful as you level them up.
Yeah.
Which means the heroes have way more impact on it right now than they're supposed to be. You know, they're supposed to be, at least in the default settings, a reasonable balance between the turrets and heroes. Obviously, there might be ways to tweak that so we can have maybe game modes with, like, you know, more focused on the heroes or more focused on the tower defense, because, you know, different players prefer different experiences. Every time. That is my experience with her. Every time, just rolls past. You don't give no fucks, like a honey badger or something.
What do you think?
Probably right in this room or something.
Or nope. Oh, come on. And of course, he decided to establish where they need to go.
Of course. Because where else would you be?
Chop, 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 chop. Get out!
The button mashing. Is that also one of the pro strats?
Yes.
Yeah, Arkell's facing.
Get out! Get out! We may die, actually.
Yeah, I'm just looking over there and Zed's dead, man. Zed's dead.
Really?
Yeah, oh shit. She's on respawn timer.
Oh, leave me alone! Oh, yeah, we're gonna die. You screw up!
It soothes my nerves to see that you still can lose.
Yeah.
You're not yet infallible on dead.
No. No, especially with the... No,
That should be an achievement, yes. We totally should have an achievement for that.
This never happened.
Damn. Should we, for the game stability, quit
again?
I could
say, you know, to continue with the Zed's dead joke, like, you know, does this man look like a... to you? You know,
what?
I shouldn't say that word on Twitch or they'll instantly demonetize us.
Yeah.
It was, you know, Pulp Fiction reference.
Ah, yeah, okay.
Because, you know, at the end when he shows up with the motorcycle and his girlfriend asks, like, whose bike is this? And he's like, oh, it's Zed's. And she asks, who's Zed?
Ah,
he's just like, Zed's dead, baby. Zed's dead.
Ah,
and,
okay, now
but,
I got it.
But, you know, throughout the whole movie, they're dealing with this crime boss, Marcellus Wallace, and they, at one point, I don't remember. If it was John Travolta's character who says it, or somebody else, but somebody says, like, you know, does Marcellus Wallace look like a, you know, the worst that would be and ends with an itch?
Okay.
So box the chapter, yeah.
Do you want 2 or 3 mods?
I'll leave it up to you. I think, you know, maybe I should focus on chat and you should focus on the game.
I'm gonna try to make only basic turrets and jelly and supports. With 2 here, because otherwise...
But you know, I was actually... When we were talking about, you know, what to title the stream, I was tempted to suggest Zed's Dead as the title here. But I thought, I'm not sure if that's a reference that everybody would get.
Ah, your favorite one.
Well, not necessarily my favorite one. My favorite one is the Plus Industry per door one. But as far as the action speed upgrades on the crystal are concerned, that's probably my favorite, because, you know, it moving 50% faster would have helped you a lot in that situation a moment ago.
It will help a lot of the situation.
Only basic plus jelly can help work if you level them up. Yeah, Arcalis, but I think his challenge is no jellies either. Just
no, jellies, yes.
No,
what are you saying?
If you say only basic turrets,
no, only the basic turret that I have.
You mean no research?
Exactly.
No research challenge is different than only basic turrets, because we have a turret that's called basic turret.
No, hold on. You can do research, but only on these 3 ones.
Yeah, no, but only starter turrets is maybe more clear, because when you say only basic turret, the thing is literally called the basic turret. Maybe we should give it a different name, because basic turret isn't really descriptive of what it is. I mean, sure, it's the one you start with, but maybe it should be called like gun turret or Gatling turret or whatever. But I guess, you know, if you build only the actual basic turrets, only the gun turrets, that's then the orc run, because it's all about more Daka.
More Daka.
G2G pull for basic turret uranium. Yeah, we should suggest that to the brand team, because, yeah, basic turret is not a super interesting game. Because, you know, the jellyfire turret could have just been called the slowdown turret or something, and that wouldn't be been interesting, but
maybe,
jellyfire
maybe
is fun.
Maybe we should try if we can have a vote for the community.
Yeah, Carlos was just suggesting that we do a vote on that.
The point is, like, which game, which number?
The boring turret. Wait, would the boring turret be made by Tesla, by one of Elon Musk's companies? Like the boring company?
The point is, like, which, because normally we tend to have 3-4 options for the community to decide. So which 3 options do you think is a nice names for the community?
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe chat has some other suggestions besides boring turret. Wouldn't the boring turret be the flamethrower one?
Ah, nice. We'll start nice.
Ah, okay. But, wouldn't the boring turret the flamethrower one, because the boring company gave away a flamethrower at one of those events and then claimed the flamethrower wasn't a flamethrower because people were being stopped at customs?
Okay.
No, you can't just call it the boring turret. It's the boring trademarks turret.
Boring TM.
The boring turret, for when you really need to drill a crystal shard.
I'm gonna have this one just in case.
That would be the boring flamer, yes. And the thing is, Subluxus, I wouldn't put it past Jeff to put a gun in here that is called the boring flamer.
No, he's not gonna allow it.
You have read all of the Dungeon of the Endless item descriptions, have you?
Not all of them, no.
There is definitely some stuff in there that is on that level. I did tell you about the King's Armor, didn't I?
I think so, yeah.
And that's the same kind of joke, where it's like, you know, making jokes about the real world. Is this the power of broom system with spawning in dark ones? Yes and no. And they're still dark rooms, but they don't automatically spawn monsters anymore. But you will not be able to place turrets in them or use any benefits you find in them, like, you know, generator slots or hero upgrade machines or research machines. And then you need to spend one of the crystal shards to power them up. But you can't power them down anymore. And the crystal shards are also used to, you know, buy upgrades on your crystal ball. So you may want to consider upgrading this thing.
Yep.
We've gotten a lot of feedback on that as well, on whether it's good or bad.
If it's enough to,
If it's good enough, or if it's bad and we should rethink it. And a lot of feedback in various directions,
which is super nice.
Which is nice, but obviously because the OpenDev isn't over yet, we're still collecting feedback, and the designers are still discussing, you know, what can be done about the feedback we've gotten. Sarkas, I missed the beginning. Oh, don't worry, you didn't miss anything at all in the beginning.
No, nothing happened.
Nothing went wrong at all when we started the stream.
It's true, it's efficient.
Yep,
you were right.
Because, you know, it's radiation damage.
Ah. I didn't thought about that. That might contribute to my lack of knowledge, let's say.
Do you know if you're going to proper Steam input support?
Steam input.
Oh, you mean for like the controller? I think so, but I'm not 100% sure. I would need to ask out to do this.
I'm gonna left the
because I'm not, you know, I don't know what's involved in fully supporting the, oh, for the Steam Deck, that I don't know. I've heard other people saying like, hey, this would be really cool on the Steam Deck, but I don't know if there's plans for that. Obviously, you know, a lot of the early pre-production of in this dungeon happened before the Steam Deck was announced, so I'm not sure if they've planned and budgeted for that. Or if this is something where it's like, if it's successful, we'll think about it, kind of thing. Can we win some keys here? A cheeky question, but sadly, you know.
What?
we don't have keys to give away for the open dev.
I don't know what, why it dies. Okay. Good job maintaining the running quick. That was a terrible wave, actually, for my side.
Yeah, so I know for a lot of players who, you know, when the open dev started and people started streaming it, they were like, oh, wait, yeah, I remember this game. They announced it a year ago. And then they realized that they would have had to sign up like 2 weeks ago to play the open dev. Then yeah, any input devices about how the game handles it, of course. But yeah, I don't know how they've programmed the game to handle things so far. And I know they're not even done with the basic controllers yet. Like, I know people have been reporting issues with the PS4 controllers.
Ah, yeah.
Where I think the bug they described was that all of the inputs were bound to the right stick.
Really?
So you would like move to the right and aim to the right and shoot all by just pushing to the right.
Okay.
So that was a bit weird.
It is.
So right now the Xbox controller is properly supported, but the PS controller isn't properly supported yet, which is also why I hesitate to make any definitive statements about whether or not Steam Deck will be supported. So, if you know, if the producer had already told us, no, we love the Steam Deck, we're totally going to support it, then maybe I would be comfortable, but we haven't talked to them about that yet.
Nope.
All the endless games to play a lot and still got no key. Yeah, I'm. I don't know the precise selection criteria for this open dev. I think it was very much mostly looking at experience with the roguelites.
Yeah.
As opposed to the endless games. Because, game experience, gameplay experience with the other endless games doesn't really translate into this.
Especially when, yeah, most of our previous games tends to be for X or strategy. Of course, this game has strategy, but not the same level of strategy.
And also very, very different because of the real-time waves. You know, can't take 20 minutes for one turn.
Yeah. They said, follow me.
I like to move with analog joystick and aim with mouse input. That's definitely not working yet because, as I say, some of the inputs are still shaky. I think the one they focused on most is the Xbox controller, and then keyboard and mouse second, because of course a lot of, especially at the office, people don't always, you know, bring their controllers from home, so it's good to have keyboard and mouse working so people can try it at the office and give their feedback. But then, you know, it's definitely not done, the implementation, as the experience with the PS4 controller shows. There was obviously a lot of missing from the interface, so I wasn't too worried about it. Yeah, the interface is definitely not done yet. Like, we don't even have our like hero/inventory screen yet.
No, we know it is going to be.
We know people have asked for it, and we know it's going to come, but it was definitely not ready.
Well, why not?
Just the name fits for Blaze so much.
Yeah.
Because of all of the years, like, yeah, sure, we have like the space western themes of like the isolation and all of that.
Mm-hmm.
But Blaze is the one where you look at him and you immediately go like, yes, western. Where some of the other heroes, visually, you would never think of it, western.
No.
Like, that already not at all. Shroom with the herbs and stuff, maybe she has kind of a shaman thing, a little bit with the plants.
Yeah.
But then she has the plague doctor mask, which kind of breaks that.
A bit, yeah.
But like Zed doesn't fit at all with the western theme visually, and some of the other heroes that we can't talk about yet.
I am.
Fit even less, in my opinion.
Yep. It's a shame that we can't say.
Is it true that the dungeons are in, wait, in real wars? That the dungeon is the habitat for the older Nazari and later first home to the Walters. You mean in the original dungeon? This is one of those things where I don't think I ever got a straight answer from Jeff. whether or not the people who crashed in Dungeon of the Endless were actually the ancestors of the Vaulters or the Mizari, or it was a different crash. I don't think I ever, you know, got him to give a definitive answer. Because there's a lot of questions you can ask Jeff where he just, you know... You know that scene in the Matrix where Neo dodges the bullets?
Yeah.
That's Jeff when you ask him the tough questions about the Endless Universe. Because he doesn't like to nail himself down, because if he nails himself down, he feels like he has to respect that in future writing.
Which makes sense, right?
But it makes some sense, but at the same time, there are so many big franchises that make retcons for good reason.
Yeah. I don't like this one.
I mean, obviously, you know, the best way would be we open all the doors and there's no spawners anywhere. Just have a smooth run.
No, but here, look, please.
There's too much coming out of that door with not enough spots, and they're right next to the generator, of course.
Yep. That's why he has half a build a super one and the three basic turrets, as you can see. He's doing their job.
Oh, one of them already leveled.
But
here you could really see that she has lower wit than the other heroes. She takes so long to upgrade the turrets.
Oh, come on. Exactly, that's my feeling, like, Jesus, just die. I'm gonna leave this one here actually. I think here is going to be the switch.
Maybe.
Or it's a bigger door.
It's a massive room. With a crystal slot actually.
Yep. Anna's chest. Railgun. In an IM-10. I
found the robots a lot easier than the bugs because a lot of them don't detect the structures. Yeah, I guess a lot of them try to go straight for your crystal, but the destroyer can really screw up a room full of defenses unless you're well set up.
I'm gonna try actually.
And I think it's already been balanced better than it was when they first implemented it. The first build I played when they had first added the destroyer, it was stupidly poor.
Yep. And especially if you have some healing bot. In this situation in which you have a lot of things.
I think the thing was really like, I don't think it did much more damage than it does now, but it was just. It was like a brick. You could shoot it and shoot it and shoot it and would just keep coming.
I'm gonna try, because as I have no other turrets, I need to do this kind of thing. I want the Daka.
Ooh. Yeah, if you don't have good turrets, the healer bots may keep the others alive and the rest leaks through. Because the healer bots are always somewhere in the back. Which I guess is why the magnetic, the EMP blast is good, because it does AoE. So it can actually hit the healer bots even in the back.
Yeah. Also the EMP.
I think the electrical damage when it does the critical hit, then it arcs between them, right? You know chain lightning kind of deal.
Yeah, but I'm not sure.
But I don't know if the turrets do that or only the guns you use yourself.
I know the blazing. I think they changed the name, but I want to say blazing, the fire turret that shoots, not the flamethrower. I think it's provoke fire when exploding the enemies.
And I think for electrical, it also has this kind of AoE effect, but it's like a chain lightning thing. Instead of, because, you know, it doesn't make sense for electricity to create a ball explosion, I guess. How many times can modules level up? I think level 3 is the maximum level. I'm not sure if that's the planned maximum level or only the current maximum level.
I think it's the planned
one. I think it's the planned one, but I'm not 100% sure. I'm still never clear if acid or electric was supposed to be better against them, as it just kind of seemed good against both types. Yeah, I think it's just the stats on the acid weapons are a bit too high at the moment.
No.
Because neither of them is to be supposed to be strong, weak against acid. And I think... Do you remember the resistance of the bugs?
The resistance of the bugs?
I know they're weak against fire, but what are they strong against?
Radioactive.
Are you sure? Wasn't that one of the unrevealed ones?
No. Should they be? I mean, the bugs are strong against radioactive, and they are weak against fire.
But if the acid is good even against the bugs, then the stats really need tuning. Because, you know, it's supposed to be strong against that. Particularly the acid Gatling was absurd. You mean this one?
No, this is actually bad against them, but I know it's a good one.
I think that, it's probably another one, right? Wait, acid and poison? No, acid and poison are kind of the same. It's a bit confusing right now, and we've already, you know, the VIPs have already brought that up, and we've told the designers that, you know, the fact that the green damage type is sometimes it's acid, sometimes it's poison, sometimes it's radioactive, is very confusing, and we should be consistent there.
No.
See the destroyers.
Come on. Are they bad or something? I don't understand anything.
But yeah, that's why it's so confusing, because yeah, with the bugs, poison resistance is logical. Then radioactive, you're like, who should be resistant against radioactive? Yeah. Because radiation is radiation. It's kind of bad for all life. But it's also bad for electronics, actually.
For everything.
They're like mechanical creepers. Yeah.
What is the switch? I'm missing the switch, I think. No, I have the door. Forget about that.
Forget about that, yeah.
Forget about everything.
He didn't say anything.
Yeah, so focus, actually.
Yeah, the destroyers have a pretty damn high resistance, unless you actually use something. Yeah, sacrificial. I think it's just inconsistent naming, and we've already
mentioned
that, and we hope that they'll make it a little more consistent. I guess technically it could be acid that is also radioactive and poisonous. I mean, a lot of the really strong acids would be poisonous if they weren't already dissolving your body.
Yeah, I think I don't know, because I wasn't in that conversation, but I guess it makes sense in a way, radioactive, when just thinking in a space, rather than poison. How you make poison?
No. Yeah, but the thing is really just whichever one of the three they pick, they should stick with one of them.
Ah, yeah.
I did have a level 2 EMP turrets, the one run I won. Might have done a lot of work. Yeah, they do a lot of work.
And
radioactive poisonous acid, RPA, aka green damage. Yep, pretty much. I mean, isn't radioactive poisonous acid basically, you know, exactly what you have in like B-movies?
B-movies?
You know, the cheaply made horror and sci-fi movies from like the 60s and 70s, where it was like, you know, oh no, these ants have mutated to be the size of houses, and it was always this kind of weird glowing green sludge from the nuclear power plant or something that was also acidic and ate through the floor and stuff like that.
Yeah. Okay, they're having fun with all my generators, and I'm gonna have fun now when they're arriving here.
Yeah, fun in the dwarf fortress sense, I see.
Yes. just look at
fun, fun with several exclamation points.
Yeah. Just look at the map.
Yeah,
they're
I saw the map.
Coming wave.
I saw the map.
Like, don't stop. Just don't stop the trigger. And also, there is one small change that they changed. I'm not sure if people realize. Like, now you can shoot with the map, but there was an exploit in which you can just shoot because you know where they're coming.
Yeah. But you can safely drink snake venom though. Yeah, I guess unless maybe you have a wound in your mouth or something and then gets into your bloodstream. But that reminds me, I saw a video a while ago about, you know, snake milking station in Australia, because they have some super poisonous snakes there, and you need to, you know, you need to milk them to
who
make.
Who would say Australia?
And you need to milk them to make antidote.
Uh-huh.
And the dude was like, you know, oh yeah, you take them, taking them out is the easy part, because you know you kind of can pin them down and then you pick them up behind the head so they can't bite you. Trying to get them back into the cage is the difficult part, because you're letting go of them, so they might come back at you. And then he was like, yeah, and you know, they asked, how many times did you get bitten? And he was like, just once. And then it turned out I'm allergic to the anti-venom. And in spite of being allergic to the anti-venom, to the thing that could quite likely kill him if he gets bitten again. He just keeps doing the job because he thinks it's important enough.
Like, fair enough, okay.
Talk about, you know, guts.
Yeah, or stupidity. I don't know how you want to call
it. Saying, yep, nuclear waste was used as a way to magic stuff back way in the day for comics and, you know, beam moves and stuff.
Yes, finally. Good one.
Ah, the sniper beam.
Nah, this is so open.
Yeah, I think it was by Barry Tassium. That video about the snake milker. And it's like, yeah, man. If I had been in that situation, I would have reconsidered my job. He's like, no. And he also said, like, you know, while he's working with it, it's fine. And then after he put them away, he starts shaking because then it starts hitting him. What he just did, because, you know, yeah, could kill him if they bite him. Sometimes I miss the 2010s. Yeah, kind of. You know, back when we could still go outside without all everything that has been going on in the last couple of years.
I'm tempted to get... I'm not sure what to get. I'm gonna get that. I'm getting so bad luck with the generator. Not getting any of them. Come on. Come on. Get out. I need Daka.
No. Heavy Gatling. Yeah, it's not that's Daka, but that's not good Daka.
That's not the good one.
You don't need some basic shooter. You need a proper snaz gun.
Yes. I need the good stuff, not the
good stuff.
All
yes.
The dark rooms now. What's happening? What the heck?
It's your username, man. Username. Like, oh, Dark Arrow's playing. It means I need to turn off the lights.
Come on. It's because it's terrible. I don't have any generator after open 5.
Oh man, yeah, this is a... Oh man.
It's like, what am I gonna do now?
Die?
No, I'm not planning to die.
I think, you know, most people don't plan to die when it happens.
I know, but it's like, what the heck? I mean, I'm confident with this weapon. I want the Daka to upgrade. More Daka. Daka, 14. The strong Daka. Oop. What is it? Everything is under control. Everything is under control. Just look at that.
Yeah, everything's fine until it's not.
Yeah. I'm not look. Oh.
Oh my god, 3 rooms that are connected. And probably both of them have spawners.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Yeah.
Where are you going? Where are you going?
It's going back to heal the gun drone.
What the heck?
Dungeon of the Endless is quite literally one of my favorite games. Looking forward to trying this and seeing if I'll enjoy it as much. It's very similar, very different too. Yeah,
that's
guess very similar and very different too is kind of the point, yes. But it's also, you know, it's why it's not called Dungeon of the Endless 2, but Endless Dungeon, because it's very similar, but very different. Hey, look, a perfectly defensible generator location. Yep.
Yeah, it's
perfectly defensible.
It's a shit location on every in all senses.
But hey, it's better than no generator at all.
But this is the only generator I have. So I have to defend it with life. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do. What should I do? I have 4 industries, so for sure I need to get open. But the risk is high.
Yep. And also you can't even like research more upgrades because it's also in the dark room.
It's like I have to. There is no plan B here.
But I guess, you know, we can be reasonably sure how to get to the room that unlocks that door. Because it's probably one of those giant rooms again.
Yeah. Come on. Hello? Okay. And now here I need to put this one to defend and pray that it's not destroyed and run. I want this.
The good Daka? No, no resources.
Yeah, that's the good Daka for me.
I mean, the resources aren't worthless, but you know, would have been really handy to find another one of those. What was it called? Light Sniper?
Yeah. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh my god.
Oh, come on, follow me.
Oh, so many. Look at the. chat can probably see it, that the massive red blob over there, like,
yes,
this
yes.
is on the line. Oh, oh, chat is giving you preliminary Fs.
No. It's not gonna happen. I just need to upgrade the Daka.
Luckily, Blaze is actually... Yes. You know, it's funny that, you know, of the three heroes in game right now, the Craver is actually the best engineer and the smartest and is the quickest at upgrading the turrets.
The confidence! You need to trust me.
Believe
on the Spanish Inquisition, please. Thank you.
Yeah, have some faith.
Yeah, and look.
I think the Jellyfire can be upgraded too.
Yeah, it's okay. But look at here. It keep it perfectly. And now the Daka level 3, it makes all the work.
Hopefully it'll do all the work. I was just playing Dungeon of the Endless and they both look very fun, but in different ways. Yeah, we'll hope they'll be fun in different ways. Because obviously, you know, this is a very different control scheme, which some people like, some people don't. For the feedback so far.
Yeah, it's a mix of opinions, to be honest.
It's a mix. I definitely enjoy having a bit more direct control, but at the same time, I do struggle with the game. But then again, I was awful at Dungeon of the Endless at first as well. And then
really?
Over time got better. And even now, I often still play on too easy.
I mean, I think I've never played on easy one. I mean, you play more hours than me on Dotti. So probably in Dotti, I would probably have like 12, 14 hours, something like that. Which is fine.
That's a plus thing, yeah. Despite the fixed camera, prefers RTS strike controls. Yep, valid point. You know, I'm mostly more of a strategy player myself. I guess we play some other games, but it's usually the strategy game. Most comfortable with the interface, I guess.
It's under control now.
You know, I could say, you know, I saw how bad I am at shooters, for example, during the Steam Next Fest.
Ah, yeah. What did you play?
Oh, I tried Metal Hellsinger and Celaco.
Mm-hmm.
The one, the latter is a shooter with some immersive sim elements, I guess, and the former is the rhythm shooter.
Mm-hmm.
And in the Celaco, I was like, oh yeah, let's play on normal difficulty because I have some shooter experience.
Yeah.
And I couldn't even make it out of the first level without constantly reloading and retrying. And on the Metal Hellsinger, I was like, yeah, I made it through. I died in the boss fight, but I was like, yeah, okay, this was the boss fight. This was the end of the demo. That's fine. And then it's like, yeah, time spent at the maximum multiplier where you know, get the vocals of the lyrics and all that, because it's kind of a score attack thing where you get score for kills and for, you know, fighting to the rhythm of the music. And it was like, time spent at the max modifier, 25%. Oh my god, I was so bad at the shooting and the killing and the keeping the rhythm. Will this have local and online co-op? Yeah, split screen, probably not, because it's... I don't think we could manage this kind of action on the split screen. Of course, with multiple PC/consoles, you can play multiplayer. So I guess you could have a LAN party, but not the talk for interface.
Yeah,
interface.
This is a bit crazy, but I want to open that door. I want that industry. I need that industry.
Yeah. But yeah, we had actually, I think they were thinking very hard about the approach, but in the end they had to do that.
No, I think
it's not gonna work because it's gonna restrict the area you can see too much.
Just look at the straight line here. There's the straight line almost.
That's the moment when you wish you had a gun with like infinite piercing and you could just stand there and shoot down the line.
Guys, this is like the matchup shooters, like. It's fine, it's everything under control. We have everything under control. Don't leave the door. I actually don't like that much. Because it's leaked the door a bit. Actually, how many? Do you have 9 minutes to finish? So I need to, yeah, I need to, yeah.
Go fast. I'm gonna look for the Sonic hat so you can gotta go fast. Looking pretty good. Yeah, the game, yes, our chances, maybe not. This is why he's playing and not I. I would never be able to even try finishing 9 minutes.
Yeah. Give me a generator. Thank you very much.
You dropped the resources. And also this door.
Yeah, but I'm gonna leave that.
Yeah, you're opening the other ones first.
Now that you mention?
Because, you know, the other ones lead right to the crystal, so they're also risky.
Everything now is risky.
That's right, yeah, it lends itself to co-op, definitely. We plan co-op with, you know, when you have multiple, let's say clients, because that's platform neutral. Oh, 45.
So close. It will happen.
It wouldn't necessarily work locally because of, you know, input and interface and all of that. So you'll need to have two separate machines to play on. But yeah, there's... In co-op, every player will control one hero then. Split the attention that way. And I guess, hopefully, be at a similar skill level so you don't have one player who spends most of their time dead. So, you know, I won't be able to play with Sergio, I guess.
Oh, I don't have any minutes.
Already spent all of them.
Yeah, in the previous ones. I'm gonna stay here, so great. Fine. Actually, if we manage to upgrade the turret level 3, I think it's fine. This one is pretty manageable, so we can just leave it here.
I mean, you kind of need to defend the industry.
Yeah,
generator.
I just need to defend the one generator.
The lonely generator you have.
I have a terrible bad luck now.
Ah, there's another one.
Yeah, but look at the spot.
Ah, right next to the door. Of course it's right next to the door. Where else would it be?
And I cannot... look, the two generators here. Oh, yeah. Yes, why not? It's like, there is no plan B, so yes.
There's no more plan B. You're already on plan Z.
Look at three generators. Look at the three generators.
Two of them in dark rooms.
It's like, what can I do? Nothing, thank you.
It's because I'm here, you know, bad luck.
Now I understand everything.
Do you think the game could benefit from auto attack, or is it against design? I'm not sure how auto attack would work here. I mean, right now it's already kind of very auto attack because, you know, there's no cooldown on your attacks unless you have the charge weapon. But that's a different issue. But yeah. If you have the rapid fire weapons, you know, you can just hold down the trigger, and when you're playing with the controller, there's actually, you can turn on some pretty significant aim assist. So it's very easy to just aim in the general direction of the enemy and hold down the trigger. With mouse, you'll have to aim a little.
They are ignoring the generator, which I thank you.
Alright, now you can go to the attack.
Yes. Let's look at now the speed, it's like one. Now the Daka is getting stronger. Almost do it.
Almost, but not quite.
You need more Daka. That's the...
I don't think there's more room in the... There's one more spot for it alone.
It will be another Daka there. No worries. Actually, these are the last ones. Fine. Yes.
But also, you know what I just realized?
What?
Does signs ever drop from like chests and barrels?
Not that I saw it.
Because I have never noticed it either. Because it would have been really useful right now.
What do we have here? Nothing. Would be interesting. Open. Now we can have DACA level 3 automatically, which is not a bad idea. Yes, I'm okay. Who doesn't want DACA level 3? Oh, Jesus. I didn't expect that all of them decided to come here, actually.
Well, of course they do, because it's the most inconvenient for you.
yes, no. Then I need more Daka.
More Daka. Always more Daka. Oh no! The crystal.
Yeah, don't worry. I have everything under control. More or less.
More or less. Yeah. As I said, everything's under control until it is.
Yeah.
It's like that the joke people make, you know. What is it? 25% of the time it works 100% of the time.
But we make it to level 3. So now I'm not scared anymore.
I have no clue when this game will be ready, but I can't wait.
Yep. That's the same spirit that we have.
We like to hear that because, you know, we feel that. Yeah, works 60% of the time, every time. Oh, hey, Arcalis, that's better than 95% chance to work in XCOM.
Ah.
Oh, I still remember that screenshot that went around one time where, you know, they were so close that the shotgun was clipping into the alien's face and the hit chance was like 60% hit chance. How do you miss when the gun is stuck in the alien's mouth?
Yeah, it's like no sense, right? Okay.
But it's you know, just like when you're playing Warhammer 40K or some game like that, it's like, you know, this is, you know, it is 10,000-year-old Primarch who specializes in close combat and should completely wipe the floor with this random dude, and then you roll all ones. Stuck on the wrong side. So that's the same, stuck on the wrong side. I'm not sure what he was talking about. Oh, perhaps the 90%, 5% chance to it is very reliable, 50-50. And the thing is, you know, it feels like that to players, but from what I remember, the XCOM devs have openly said that actually the 90% chance to it is actually more like 99% chance, because they wanted it to feel good for players.
Yeah.
And the players still remember every time they miss the 95% chance.
Well, I understand that. I think we're gonna manage it. We're going into the right direction. Yes,
well, you have 1 minute left.
I know,
You can finish the floor in 1 minute. But actually, we only have 1 minute left. Let me turn off the alarm so it can go off on screen.
Come on. I'm just going straight. The pressure!
Yep. But that is probably the exit door.
Yes, it is. So I'm gonna just allow me to finish it, please.
No, I'm gonna hit start streaming just before you do. I'm gonna watch the crystal bot's progress more closely, and then when it has just a tick left, I hit stop streaming.
Like, no.
or I switch to the camera so nobody can see that you won.
No, that would be horrible.
Yeah, you know what, we should have set it up so we have the roundabout thing from JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, so that just as you're about to win, we hit the button and then then it just grays out and has the to be continued.
I think with the level 3, we are gonna manage.
Will there be meta progression? Yes.
Yes.
But that's all we can say for now.
Yeah.
If we say more, the brand team will send the cleaner after us.
Yeah. Like, do you work here? Not tomorrow. No, it's not the same.
Yeah, do you work here? Not anymore now.
Just look at the lack of level 3.
Yep.
They just do everything.
Ah, yes. The bin man is always watching, indeed.
And, you know what? I'm gonna switch.
Just in time, and
just
I think actually it's 8 o'clock and 1 minute.
Sorry for those of you that didn't trust on me. Sorry, but it was nice.
Always like the difficulty modes in Dungeon of the Endless, easy and too easy. Yeah, we got away with that in Dungeon of the Endless because, you know, it was very much aimed at the very hardcore roguelite crowd, I guess, even though we didn't have real meta progression there. I don't think we'll have that in Dungeon of the Endless because, you know, it is intended to also be accessible to more casual players.
Yeah.
and you don't get away with too easy and easy when addressing the casual. It was already right. bad enough on Dungeon of the Endless. There were so many threads on Steam. Like, oh, what the F is wrong with this game? I'm playing on easy and I'm getting my ass kicked.
You need to get used to that. I don't know. I am the one in favor that they would like to have some kind of a high difficulty level, or maybe that the meta progression affects the difficulty.
Yeah, there'll definitely be some way to adjust the difficulty level, I guess. But we can't talk about any of that yet.
Nope.
You'll have to wait and see.
I'm just wondering if there will if there is anyone on Dungeons of the Endless. Can you imagine if there is someone? It will be actually.
You put the controller down on the space bar.
It's like, what the heck is happening? You're not seeing on the screen, okay? But this is really stupid.
The adrenaline of the rush hasn't worn off yet.
Yeah.
Demon Bell intensified, I guess.
There is no one. Okay, no, it's okay.
Not surprising. So I guess we're going to switch over to some Humankind in French.
Yep.
Part two of... Was it yesterday when we raided him?
What?
Yeah. Was it last week?
Yeah, no, last stream was.
I just didn't remember if it was yesterday or.
No. It was the same person. It was Dark Patator. I think it's Patator, right? Yes, Patator. Yep. And also, I think this is going to be the last stream of Endless Dungeon.
Probably the last stream.
Probably it's going to be the last stream.
Because, yeah, as we realized, you know, a few days ago when a colleague was like, no, you can't post this on Thursday because Thursday is a bank holiday here, and we were like, oh yeah. Wait, right, so we won't be around on Thursday to stream again.
I say the Independence Day or the Revolution. Is it a revolution or independence?
Not independence.
The revolution day.
You know, where they celebrate the storming of the Bastille. And
I know, but
that's not, you know, that's not considered independence. It's like, yeah, I think do they call it Bastille Day?
Yeah,
I
think Bastille. They do. Yeah, the Bastille. Yeah, it is right. But in any case, hopefully we can get more endless dungeon, even though the OpenDev is finished. We're not sure. Hopefully,
Obviously, also we don't have that much more to show in the build.
Exactly. We can try. It would be nice if we can show how the things is going to, like, you know, when we add new things, it would be nice to show. But we are not gonna do any promises. Yes,
we are, unfortunately, you know. I know some companies do that a lot.
Yeah, I know.
But I don't think we have quite gotten our brand and production teams there to allow us to show work in progress stuff.
But
you can
ask for that. You should ask or
if
social media.
Yeah, exactly.
Growth,
you know,
like,
go ahead and spam games together in the socials and with, hey, two streams of the dev build, and then maybe we can convince them that we can do
that. Just get Stephanie, Jordan, and Sergio doing streams there.
You know, so hot code. You know, when we're like, you know, hey, we're going to show you this, and the program has finished implementing it 2 hours ago, so everything might be broken.
But it's nice. But anyways, it's coming too late. So hopefully you have enjoyed the stream as much as we do, and you have enjoyed this kind of a strange run with the DACA mod.
I mean, at the end, after you had the upgrade, it was going really well.
Yeah, it was really well.
In the middle, it was a bit shaky.
Yeah, but well. And have a nice weekend for all of you that don't work, because I know some of you may work, and see you around. Bye.